Stemmedicker, noble care for human nature. Tumor microenvironment. Our immune systems, including NK cells, dendritic cells, and T cells, protect our body from cancer. In normal immune systems, as soon as cancer cells or mutant cells are created, immune cells detect them and remove them immediately. If so, how is the tumor developed? In weak immunity, more cancer cells survive than cancer cells are killed by immune cells. Most anti-cancer drugs have been developed targeting cancer antigens. Surviving cancer cells gradually acquire immune evasion capabilities, including reduced expression of cancer antigens binding immune cells and immune checkpoint inhibitors. Eventually, cancer cells surrounded by stromal cells and weakened immune cells form a tumor. Tumors promote an immunosuppressive environment, called tumor microenvironment, allowing cancer cells to grow and spread by evading the immune system. How is the tumor microenvironment formed? The key is an altered energy metabolism in cancer cells. All cells take up glucose from blood vessels to make the energy needed for cell survival, called ATP. This process is called energy metabolism. Glucose absorbed into cells is broken down into pyruvates. In normal cells, pyruvates move to the mitochondria to make ATP using oxygen. Mitochondria are energy factories that produce ATP essential for cell survival. It is called oxidative phosphorylation. Then, how is the energy metabolism of cancer cells different from that of normal cells? Cancer cells changed their energy metabolism to establish tumor microenvironment for their survival. Cancer cells make energy not using mitochondria but by converting pyruvate into lactate via lactate dehydrogenase enzyme, called LDHA, which is abundant in most cancer cells. It is called aerobic glycolysis, better known as the Warburg effect. As a result, lactates and hydrogen ions having cytotoxicity are increased inside cancer cells, and cancer cells release them to the outside of cancer cells for survival. Released lactates and hydrogen ions form tumor microenvironment with high lactate concentration and low pH. In the tumor microenvironment, a high level of lactate inhibits the proliferation of approaching immune cells, especially cytotoxic T cells and NK cells. In the tumor microenvironment, low pH promotes the degradation and aggregation of antibody therapeutics, leading to the inhibition of binding to cancer antigens and the evasion of immune responses. How can we get rid of the tumors? By overcoming the tumor microenvironment. Stemmedicker developed an innovative anti-tumor extracellular vesicle treatment that can normalize the tumor microenvironment. It is called MBTC-ADEVs. MBTC80EVs contain LDHB and PGC1 alpha inside and express HLA-G proteins on their surface. HLA-G can help MBTC80EVs to pass through the tumor microenvironment and to be absorbed by cancer cells. PGC1 alpha is the controller of intracellular LDH enzymes. So, the level of LDHA in cancer cells is reduced by PGC1 alpha in MBTC80EVs, and the level of LDHB is increased. LDHB is the enzyme converting lactate to pyruvate. In most solid tumors, the level of LDHB is very low, but the level of LDHA is very high to establish tumor microenvironment. An elevated level of LDHB by PGC1 alpha in MBTC80EVs can convert lactate to pyruvate in cancer cells. Pyruvate moves to mitochondria for OxBHOS and energy metabolism is normalized. The releases of lactate and hydrogen ions are reduced, so the tumor microenvironment by high lactate and low pH is normalized by MBTC80EVs. As a result, the immune cells can recognize the cancer antigens and eliminate the tumors through normal immune responses. MBTC80EVs can normalize the tumor microenvironment and energy metabolism of cancer cells, leading to inducing their apoptosis. So, MBTC80EVs can use alone or with other immunotherapies, including CAR-T, CAR-NK, immune checkpoint inhibitors, and monoclonal antibodies.